Hello everyone and welcome back to Palace Zoo. I'm really excited today to share with you what I've built today. It's something really big and grand and really inviting to the zoo itself. Well, more to the palace actually. Today is more of a palace episode than a zoo episode, if I'm being honest, but that's also the thing I really enjoy about this zoo, that not only the animals matter, but I really want to focus on architecture too. So, here I'm building like a sort of cascade stairway to up the hill. I used a lot of inspiration from some pictures my good friend Tark sent me again. He really sent me a lot of pictures I'm using today. So, just a limestone stairway up the hill. But there's something cool about this. There's like in the middle, multiple dozens of little fountain holes pouring down water down the hillside into like little basins, that's basically it for that cascade thing. What's so special about it? But it looks really cool. But anyway, first we need to of course construct some stairs. I mean, I could have used paths up that hill, but it wouldn't look nearly as good as like faking it with like roof tiles here. It's a bit more work this, of course, but it's also easier to control and to perfect. That's a tip for me. If you're making stairs, just fake it. Don't bother with the pathing system, because it's really hard to work with. So here I'm making the little basins, and in these little basins I tried to put like water, and I did manage it in the end, but it's like hard to do, and so all the terrain work and the water tool is also a bit finicky in Planet Zoo, so there's water in there, but not as much as I would have wanted in the end. But I faked it with like the water foam and the fountain stuff. And here I'm going further up the hill with the stairs, and this is the top. I had to equalize the length a bit for make everything fit a bit more. I'm really happy with how this turned out today, and I had fun building it. I built it yesterday and today a bit, and I really started to get a workflow of this type of content I'm doing now. That brings me to the subject I want to talk about too. I'm gonna uphold like a set upload schedule. I'm gonna upload 3 videos a week minimal. So that's Monday will be a franchise zoo that I'm starting, which I'm really excited about. To like, it's basically gonna be like this, but also with some real-time management of the zoo. It's like a nice in-between. So that's on Monday, and on Wednesday is Planet Coaster content. Now I know like most of you don't really care about theme parks and stuff, but if you care about architecture and infrastructure of parks and zoos, and if you just want to have a good laugh, or you like my commentary or anything, just I recommend watching the Blueport Pleasure Beach episode 2. That's the thing I've started with my good friend Wix last week, and there's now 2 episodes. So that's on Wednesday, the collab, and maybe Jollywood for the, that's also a Planet Coaster thing. So I'm alternating every week between those two, and then on Friday is gonna be Palace Zoo. I know like Palace Zoo is pretty much the thing people watch my channel for the most part. So I'm really trying to do that justice and making as much as I can. I'm still having fun with it. I'm not gonna burn myself out with this, but yeah. And then besides that, so Monday, Wednesday and Friday, besides those 3 days, I'm gonna fill it up with maybe career mode videos. That's just mostly for myself, because I just want to finish the career. Most of you have probably already watched it or played it yourself. But I'm going to get all gold medals there, so if you want to watch that, that's also out there. So that's filler, and upcoming week or somewhere like in the near future, I'm going to do one less spore episode just to finish the game off. We had 4 episodes of spore now, with each stage basically is one video. So the last stage is the space stage, and that's a long phase. This is gonna be a long video, like maybe an hour or so even, But I'm looking forward to doing that. But yeah, basically, I just want to streamline my channel a bit and the content I'm like making and the games I'm playing on here. So yeah, mostly gonna be Planet Zoo for now. Let's get back to the build. Yes, so that was the finished cascade. You see these all little holes and stuff. There's water coming out of it, and I'm really happy with the result. Yeah, so this is a flower garden. I wanted to extend the gardens a bit. I could have done more fountains, but I thought like a garden would like alternate it a bit more. And these flowers you can see from the palace at the other side of the garden. So I thought that was cool because it's on a hill facing the palace. Yeah, I'm just finishing some hedges here. And of course a railing here for people not to fall off. I just really like how this... How it looks. Yeah, it's look like it's just one massive stairway that like invites you to go on it. It's well, except for maybe people in like wheelchairs and stuff, but that's maybe an issue. But like canonically, it was built a long time ago, so I may build a ramp later next to it, like a little trail. But I haven't come to that yet, yeah. But yeah, I'm probably gonna do that, yes, okay. But anyway, here I'm starting on the main part of this episode. Le Monumento, the monument. It's like a big archway modeled after another picture Tark sent me. I don't know exactly the name of it, but it's also very much like the Gloriette from Schönbrunn. Only a bit more, I would say... squarish. It's not as round and a bit more modern, I think. It's also easier to build in Planet 2. That's why I chose to do that, and I'm really happy with the end result, and it just looks so majestic and cool at the end of the gardens, especially at night. You will see that later, or maybe you've already seen that in the first few seconds of this video. But yeah, luckily, this is a lot of copying and placing it down again, instead of like having to make everything individual. So, it didn't cost me as much time as I thought it would have. So I'm happy with that. And yeah. Also, next episode is gonna be really fun and really animal orientated again. I think I might have to split it up in two episodes because it's a pretty big project. So, Targ, again, who always gives me good feedback and stuff, he asked me if he could have a bigger role in the zoo. So, he is designing, he designed actually by this point, pretty much, a complete Indian elephant and Bengal tiger habitat thing that's looking so cool. I love it, and I'm gonna basically build it in a zoo, give my own twist to it in some regard. But it's gonna be very modern and very now-ish. It's very zoo-ish. So a real contrast from this episode. So I'm looking forward to doing that. I'm also open to that for any other people who have like great ideas and of course like sketches and stuff. They or like can't play the game themselves and want someone to build their things for me. If I think it like fits well with the zoo and it looks very good, then. Just send me some pictures on Discord or Twitter or here. Just hit me up if you have any cool ideas. So actually, we're nearly finished with this monument thing already, and you can really start to see the main shape of it. It looks very majestic, especially at the end of the gardens. This is the one thing you immediately sets. How do you say that? It's a weenie, basically. As in theme park terms, it's something you immediately see, and it's an icon for the park. Of course, this isn't in the actual zoo itself, but it is also a thing that draws people to it. Now, I've also received even more feedback from the last episode. That's great. That's also going to be in the next episode, like adjusting the hedges a bit, covering up the hay. Stacks to prevent it from getting wet and all of that stuff. So and that's for next episode too. Actually the big animals, they are coming now to the zoo finally. Like I've got, of course, the Bengal tigers and elephants are pretty massive for the next episode or two. But after that, probably African animals, like zebras, and Asian animals like the bear, the Asian bear. I'm not going to do North American animals. That's for another zoo, probably. But I'm really having having fun coming up with some ideas for other habitats and giving it a bit of a modern, more of a modern vibe. Also, since I'm starting that franchise zoo this next week, if you have any cool ideas for like a name or a theme or a location, let me know. I was thinking maybe doing a Dutch one since I'm Dutch myself, and we have now enough foliage that I basically can convince people that it would be a Dutch zoo. Also, Holland is very flat, so I don't have to do a lot of terraforming, but I can like really get the environment into the game a bit more and maybe do a cool story around it. I don't know. Maybe you have some cool idea in your head. A safari ride could be done, but that's not really a franchise thing. Oh my god. We could make a safari zoo once. Just like that's the main thing, the safari ride, and then there's a little park or a house. I don't know. I went to one in England. I forgot the name of it, but it was pretty cool. I've also decided to show a bit of the lighting that I did. It looks so good at night. I say it myself, but still, just the lighting in Planet Zoo is amazing, and I'm really happy with how they implemented it. I'm doing some rock work, by the way, to flesh it a bit more out, this area. And in one of the last episodes, I'm gonna do the entire surrounding area, the trees and stuff, perfect it all, make it look like one big picture. But for now, I'm just painting the picture I want to see from this perspective for now. Anyway, we're nearly at the end of the episode again. If you enjoyed this, please subscribe for more of this content and give a like. Give a comment, what are your thoughts? Would you like to see anything in the zoo? Stuff like that. Anyway, thanks for watching. Bye! Thank you.